Hello guys, welcome to Daily Current Affairs series. Today we will discuss about 16th September Current Affairs. Myself Sunny Sandeep. Welcome to our channel Gear Up for Group 1 Exam. Let us discuss the today's important current affairs, that is new bill on powers of Delhi government and Lieutenant Governor soon. Here there is an ongoing parliament session. In that session, Minister of Home Affairs, that is MHA, is likely to introduce a legislation to amend 1991 Act. In that session, Minister of Home Affairs want to introduce a legislation to amend 1990 Act. Here, the Union Territory of Delhi with a legislative assembly came into being in 1991 under Article 239 WA. Inserted by the Constitution 69th Amendment Act 1991. Here we have to remember Article 239 WA deals about the Legislative Assembly of Union Territory of Delhi. Here, according to this 1991 Act, our existing Act, the Legislative Assembly of Delhi has the power to make laws in all matters except public order, police and land. These are the three exceptions, that is public order, police and land. Remaining all matters, they can Legislative Assembly of Delhi can make any laws related to that one. Here, what is the new bill? That is pertaining to the powers and functions of Delhi government and Lieutenant Governor. Here in this bill is about all about the functions and powers of the Delhi government and Lieutenant Governor. Here, moreover, by this bill, more discretionary power given to Lieutenant Governor only. Next one, US welcomes India's role in Afghan peace talks. We know that Afghan peace talks are going on. In that, India took the plunge on engaging with the Taliban at the first intra-Afghan negotiations, that is INA, the first intra-Afghan negotiations. Here, there is a US special envoy on Afghanistan, that is Zalmay Khalilzad, met with the External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar and National Security Advisor Ajit Doval and Foreign Secretary also in this meeting. In that US special envoy Zalmay Khalilzad has appreciated India on the Afghan peace talks. The two sides discussed future steps and possible cooperation between India and United States in furthering the Afghan peace process. Here, India should play a key role in intra-Afghan peace talks. Why? Because if suppose US pulled out from that Afghanistan, there may be a chances of occupying that Afghanistan by Taliban or by China or by Pakistan also. These are the three major. Here, if you see that Ashraf Ghani government in Afghanistan, that's why it is related to civilian government. If civilian government want to sustain in that, India's assistance or India's relationship is must and should. That's why India should play a key role in that intra or Afghan peace talks. Next one, Ajit Doval walks out of Shanghai Cooperation Organization interaction. Why Ajit Doval walks out of from this interaction? There is a virtual meeting between these countries or SCO countries, that is Shanghai Cooperation Organization. In that, there are eight member countries having. First one, China, Kazakhstan, third one, Kyrgyzstan, fourth one, Russia, fifth one, Tajikistan, sixth one, Uzbekistan, and seventh one, India, and eighth one, Pakistan. Here, first of all, apart from central countries, that is Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Russia, Tajikistan, Uzbekistan, these are the central countries. Apart from, if you see that China and Pakistan as well as the opponent to the India. That's why they are, if you see the last 4 decades or 5 decades, they are aggravating or they are more high or getting highly tensions between India, China and India, Pakistan. That's why if you see that last month Pakistan has claimed or Pakistan has released new map regarding the, it is claiming that all Jammu and Kashmir are part of, our entire Jammu and Kashmir is a part of Pakistan and previous settled Junagadh and Mandavar. are also in the part of Pakistan. That's why India responded strongly after Pakistan displayed the newly unveiled political map. That is a political map. Here, Pakistan uses a fictitious map as a backdrop for its representative depicting the sovereign Indian territories. Here there is a Shanghai Cooperation Organization, that is SCO Charter. From this SCO Charter, we have to know that in this SCO Charter is giving importance to the protecting the sovereignty and territory of any country. That's why Pakistan has violating this SCO Charter. Here, what is the response of Russia in this situation? Russia does not support that what Pakistan has done and hopes that Pakistan's provocative act will not affect India's participation in SCO. That's why Russia also is against that Pakistan move. That's why here we have to know that for our competitive exams, what are the countries, what are the member states in SCO apart from dialogue partners and some other countries. And next one, this what is the use of Shanghai Cooperation Organization? That is the motto, or that is the what we have to learn from this article. Next one, AIIMS Darbhanga. Here, Union Government or Union Cabinet has approved the establishment of new All India Institute of Medical Sciences, that is AIIMS, at Darbhanga in Bihar. Here, this will be established under the Pradhan Mantri Swasthya Suraksha Yojana. Very, very important. AIIMS are under, in the first phase, all these AIIMS, new AIIMS are constructing under the Pradhan Mantri Swasthya Suraksha Yojana. Very, very important. PMSSY. Here, if you see the objective, why? What is the use or what is the objective of introducing the or establishment of new AIIMS? That is, the objective is to establish the new AIIMS institution of national importance for providing quality tertiary healthcare. Tertiary healthcare means third level. First one primary and second one secondary and third one, that is tertiary healthcare. Here medical education and nursing education and research in the medical or medicines. That's why here we giving the importance to the medical. From this situation, from this COVID-19 situation, we know that or we have to urge that we have to give importance to the medicals, our medical system. That's why our Union Cabinet has approved the establishment of a new All India Institute of Medical Sciences at Darbhanga in Bihar. With this, we can conclude our video. Thanks for watching. Like, share and subscribe to our channel. Gear up for Group 1 exam. This is Sunny Sandeep signing out. Take care and bye-bye.